This is my 2016 Toyota Tacoma, which many of you guys are very familiar with. If you've been on my channel for any amount of time, you know that this truck is heavily featured here. But nonetheless, unless you've been with me for the last, 3 years or so, you may not be familiar with all of the modifications that I've made to the truck. And I continue to get questions from people about specific changes that I've made. And although all of those videos are kind of spread out throughout the last few years on my channel, I figured it'd be helpful to make one compilation video that just talks about all the modifications that I've made to the truck, provide links to all of those items in the description below, and links to all of the installation videos. I've pretty much done all of the modifications myself, so if you're curious about any of these changes, those links will be in the description below. If you're not familiar with the Tacoma, this 2016 model is the first year of the third generation model. This is the TRD off-road trim package, which has the multi-terrain select system with crawl control, a locking rear differential. We get unique TRD off-road wheels and tires. These have been changed since then. We also get Bilstein off-road shocks and an additional skid plate. This is also the double cab model, so we've got the four full doors, and then it's also the long bed with the 6-foot bed. First modification is the TRD Pro faux grille. This is from Cali Raised Off-Road. It's about $280. Great product. It is a perfect fit to the truck. You use the factory hardware to install it. No modifications are required. And it's actually a very simple installation. I've got a friend with a 2017 TRD off-road who also has the TRD Pro grill. His is the OEM grill. We compared the two side by side, and the difference between the two is very subtle. It actually took us quite a while to even find anything that was different. The only thing is that the shading of the lettering on the grill is just slightly off. But unless you had the two trucks side by side and you spent a good 5 minutes comparing them, you're probably never gonna notice that. I've been very pleased with this product. Looks very much like that OEM grill. Another cool modification that I've made to the truck, if you peek through here, you'll see we've got a hidden winch. Along with that, my little custom license plate here, if we pull it off, got the lead fairing right here to the winch. So we've got a hidden winch, and then my little $3.92 modification here, just use some cabinet hardware to attach this. It's traveled several thousand miles with me with no issue. The other nice thing is that it hides some of the imperfections from where the license plate was previously mounted to the bumper. So pretty nice little setup there. Go ahead and pop the hood real quick so I can give you a better look at this product. To install this, I used a winch mount from Hidden Winch Mount Specialists. It is, I think, $490. All the specifics again are down below. And I did have to powder coat it, so that was another $60 or so. It was perfect fitment to the truck. You can kind of see the winch down in there. A little tricky to see. But the winch mount was perfect fitment for the truck. All of the holes are cut exactly where you need them. It's specific to the Tacoma. You basically remove the factory bumper, which is aluminum, replace it with the winch mount, which is definitely tougher, so it may be a little bit more durable in a crash as well. Put that mount on, and then I've got the Rough Country 9500 Pro Series winch with a synthetic rope back behind there. The winch itself was $400. Probably not the best winch out there, but it's a whole lot cheaper. And I have gotten the truck stuck one time in some pretty deep snow, and it got me out no problem. It's not a wireless winch, so that's kind of one downside with it. But again, it's a lot more affordable than some of the other options that are out there. And the nice thing is that you can see we've still got good access through the engine compartment down to that winch. So I keep the cable inside the truck. If you get it stuck, just put that cable down through there, wrap it through the driver's side window, and you can operate it when getting yourself unstuck. Last change up here at the front of the truck is that I've done some LED lighting upgrades. Low beams have been upgraded, as well as the fog lights, to a JDM Astar product. Been very pleased with both of those. Huge improvement in light quality at nighttime. See the road a whole lot better. Also gives the truck a really nice look because you're getting rid of that yellow light and you've got more of a bluish light, which also blends in really nicely with the LEDs. So great products on both of those. Highly recommend LED lighting upgrades. That's one of the cheapest things that you can do to upgrade your truck. Very easy installation, and again, improves the look of the truck and the functionality. Originally, after getting the truck, I did a 2-inch Rough Country spacer in the front and a 1-inch Toytec block in the rear, $160 all in, and I did the installation myself with a friend. And then later, I upgraded to a larger set of wheels and tires. And so when I did that, I upgraded the suspension as well. That again has all been documented on my channel. For the suspension setup, I've got the Icon Stage 2 setup. So up here, factory fitment with the front shock. This setup was $2,050, I believe. It includes full lift for the truck. So we had the front shock, and then at the rear of the vehicle, we get new shocks as well as an add-a-leaf. I've got the front of the truck sitting about 2.25 inches higher than the factory height. And then at the rear, we're sitting at about 1.5 inches higher. So at the rear, again, we got the shocks, and then we've got the add-a-leaf. And unfortunately, I didn't get the advertised 1.5 inches of lift. But again, I had that original Rough Country and Toytec block lift. So I just went ahead and put the Toytec block back in conjunction with the add-a-leaf to get the lift that I needed. I think the reason that I wasn't getting the advertised height is because my truck is a long bed, so it's probably heavier back here, and the add-a-leaf wasn't quite as functional at lifting the truck to that full height. So again, $2,050 plus the additional $100 for the Toytec block. Pretty pleased with this suspension overall. It is a little bit rougher than that factory setup, but it performs pretty well. It's got a nice look to it and does seem like a pretty high quality product. As far as wheels and tires, I've got the VTX Rogue wheels in 17 inches, and then a set of Goodyear Wrangler Duratrax in a 285/70 R17. Now, with the 285/70 R17s, sometimes you can get those to fit without too many modifications to the truck, but with these VTX Rogue wheels, it's got a minus 10 offset. So you'll see that the wheels and tires are coming out pretty far from the truck. Gives it a really aggressive look. I'm very pleased with this setup from that standpoint. But the one downside is that with that offset, you get some pretty serious rubbing. So back here, I've done a cab mount chop. Basically, this is the cab mount. It originally stuck out about this far. You cut it back to that location to get the additional clearance we need for turning. Along with that, the inner fender liner here, I had to kind of push that forward a little bit with a heat gun and do a slight cut to the fender. You also notice that the driver and front passenger window have been tinted just slightly. They are both tinted to the Oregon legal limit. I wish I would have bent the rules just a little bit on that. Trying to be a law-abiding citizen, but I wish that I got a little bit more privacy and a little bit more blocking of the intense sun on really bright days, but still a nice improvement that we get with this. $100 to tint those two windows. And coming around to the back, I've got the Toyota OEM exhaust tip. You can get this in either chrome or black. $60 and a super easy installation. It's just got a little bracket on here and you just screw it on tight. Gives a nice appearance to replace the kind of cheap look that you get with the tailpipe otherwise. And then coming around to the back, again, some LED lighting upgrades here. Replace the reverse lights with LED bulbs, and likewise the license plate lights. So pretty minor modifications, but again, backing up at nighttime, those are a whole lot brighter, really helps with visibility. Gives a really nice white look on the back of the truck with both those and the license plate lights. So those are the upgrades that I've made to the truck. In some ways, it's a little bit minor compared to what you see with some other Tacomas that are out there. I like the fact that it just kind of spruces up the truck a little bit, makes it unique in its own right, and I'm really pleased with the overall package that I've got here with the truck. As far as future modifications, there's a few possibilities that I've kind of tossed around in my head, but probably not gonna get real crazy from here. Love to get your comments or questions in the section below. If you have any feedback, feel free to share those thoughts. For more videos of the third generation Tacoma, be sure to subscribe. In the meantime, thanks for watching.